दहेज दिया जाता है, उसके बाद लड़की को कुछ होता है। दहेज ये भी हमें सोचना पड़ेगा कि दहेज औरतों के पास रहता है, जो आप प्रेजेंट देते हैं, जो कैश देते हैं, वो कहाँ जाता है, जो शादी का खर्चा होता है वो कहाँ जाता है, वो लड़की तो इस्तेमाल नहीं कर पाती। आप पुलिस स्टेशन में चले जाइए, वहाँ पे रिट्रीवल है डाउरी का, देखिए किस तरह से टूटी फूटी कुर्सियाँ, टूटी फूटी मेजें या चीजें जो घर की पड़ी रहती है, उससे लड़की का क्या फायदा, उसको वापस मिल जाए तो क्या वो रह सकती है? अगर शादी टूट जाए तो दहेज के बल पे उसका कोई भी फायदा होता है सेपरेशन के टाइम या डिवोर्स के टाइम या कभी भी? तो इन कुछ सवालों को उठा के हम अपना बंद करते हैं।
थैंक यू वेरी मच, आपने बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से पूरा एक कॉन्टेक्स्ट सेट किया और क्लियरली बताया है कि किस तरह से ये कानून अभी इस स्थिति तक पहुंचा है, व्हाट इज द जो रूट लिया उस कानून ने वो क्या था, और अब क्या क्या ऐसी दिक्कतें हैं जिनसे हमें और फोकस करने की जरूरत है, क्या कानून को इम्प्लीमेंट करने में क्या दिक्कतें आ रही हैं, किस तरह से पूरा जो एक स्पिरिट था इस कानून का उसको बिल्कुल ही उल्टा कर दिया गया है जजमेंट के तौर पे। अब मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी संध्या से, जो हमें एक एज अ प्रैक्टिशनर इस कानून को इस्तेमाल करते हुए किस तरह की दिक्कतें आती हैं एज अ लॉयर, वो हमें थोड़ा सा उसके ऊपर बताएंगे।
थैंक यू सो मच अनुभव। एक्चुअली मैं हिंदी और इंग्लिश मिक्स करके बात कर रही हूँ क्योंकि माई हिंदी इज कोलोकियल हिंदी।
It's a very complex issue, and how to deal with it is something, especially with me as an advocate, as practicing advocate, especially dealing with this issue, we find it very, very difficult actually. Now, हम लोग एक्चुअली जब हम लोग हमारे पास एक औरत आती है और यूजली हमारे पास लोग आते हैं ये बोलकर नहीं आते कि हमको डाउरी हैरेसमेंट हुआ है, हम लोग उसके पास आते हैं कि हमको डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस के हिसाब से हमारे पास लोग आते हैं, एंड जब हम उनसे बात करते हैं तो पीछे जब हम लोग देखते हैं उसका इन बेसिकली वो कॉन्सिक्वेंस इज डाउरी इज वन ऑफ द मेन इश्यूज, बिकॉज हम लोग जब पूछते हैं कितना मिला दे डिमांडेड हम लोग को 2 लाख में एक एट 2 लाख रुपया हमसे मांगा एंड 30 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड, और हम लोग को एंड इनफैक्ट 2 लाख एंड और 2 लाख 3 लाख और 30 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड और 15 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड फॉर अ पर्सन हु इज एट जस्ट स्टार्टअप एक ऑर्डिनरी फैमिली टू मैनेज 30 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड, फॉरगेट द रेट ऑफ गोल्ड एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, एक 5 साल पहले या 10 साल पहले 30 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड और 40 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड इज लाइक ए ह्यूज अमाउंट, एंड टू अरेंज दैट अमाउंट एंड एस्पेशली इन अ केरला सेटिंग इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट वेयर विमेन आर ऑल्सो एजुकेटेड, द पेरेंट्स हु आर डेली वेज अर्नर्स से 1 लाख रुपया अरेंज करना एंड टू अरेंज द 30 sovereigns ऑफ गोल्ड इज लाइक वो लोग अपना घर को ही गिरवी रखकर बनाते हैं, और दे टेक लोन फ्रॉम मनी लेंडर्स ऐसे, एंड व्हेन दे कम बैक तो केसेस में आते हैं तो इट्स लाइक दिस लेडीज आर दिस गर्ल्स आर बीटन अप लाइक एनीथिंग, बीटन अप ब्रूटली, और पुलिस स्टेशन में हम लोग पूछे आप लोगों ने पुलिस स्टेशन में कंप्लेन किया था? हाँ कंप्लेन किया था, तो कुछ हुआ नहीं, वापस भेज दिया हमको, नथिंग, कोई केस भी रजिस्टर एट द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस तो केस रजिस्टर ही नहीं होता, बिकॉज दे से कि मेरी फैमिली हैज टू बी मेंटेन, लाइक जब अनुभव बोल रही थी उस फैमिली सेटअप को मेंटेन करने के लिए, क्योंकि अगर समझ लो उसको पुलिस स्टेशन में बुलाया एंड ही गेट्स पुलिस स्टेशन में बुलाया ये बोलकर उसको बाद में मारपीट होगा, ठीक है क्यों मारपीट हुआ, स्पीकर आया था, लेकिन ये स्पीकर आकर मारपीट हो रहा है कि तुम घर से बस इतना ही लेकर आए और ज्यादा लेकर नहीं आए। क्यों लेकर नहीं आए? क्योंकि मे बी उन्होंने बोला आपका 50,000 रुपीज बाद में दे देंगे, या अभी तुम 20 सॉवरेंस अभी रखो, 10 सॉवरेंस बाद में दे देंगे। ये बोलकर वो बाकी वापस लेकर आओ, पर अभी चाहिए लेकर आओ करके। तो इन दिस काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन दिस वुमन नीदर डज शी इज शी एम्पावर्ड। इफ वी टेक दिस काइंड दिस पर्टिकुलर वुमन दिस लेडी विल नॉट इवन वांट शी wants to get, may not want to get out of the marriage, but she doesn't go, 90% she does not want to get out of the marriage, not because of any feeling of empowerment, but she doesn't want to get out because if she goes back home, that entire 1 lakh rupees which her mother would have, parents would have arranged, and that already 20 sovereigns of gold would have already, she will not get it back, and then she will be again a burden on her family who's already घर को उन्होंने डीबे रखा हुआ है। एंड पुलिस स्टेशन में कंप्लेंट व्हेन दे गो इफ दिस इशू दो दे डू नॉट से एनीथिंग, इट इज द इशू व्हिच एक्चुअली कम्स इन इज ओनली हस्बैंड ने मुझे मारा। क्यों मारा? यू नो पीटर आया था, पुलिस ऑल्सो दे राइट देयर ओन स्टेटमेंट, टू दे से कि घर में पीटर आकर मारा, एफआईआर ऑल्सो विल नॉट बी लॉस्ट। देयर वाज एन इंस्टेंस वेयर दिस लेडी वाज बर्न, put up 40% burn, and it was a clear case of dowry harassment. But again, they did not, when the police came to take a statement, she did not say that her husband and her family had done it, because she wanted that, she knew that she might not survive, she felt that she might not survive, her child of 1 year is there, they will have to look after, because her family may not be able to look after. Let me just say that, I accidentally got burned by the stuff, though she was pushed by the mother-in-law. And after the police washed away the case, what had happened was, she miraculously recovered. The husband deserted her, the family also, the in-laws family also were like totally, they did not look after, they did not turn back on the child also, and it was after 5 years she comes to us saying, can we do something? When I say the fact that she was burnt kind of came to her advantage, because when she went to the police station to lodge a complaint based on her representation, the police immediately lodged the 498A, because that was after 5 years, there is a delay, but after 5 years they lodged an FIR. He got so scared he went away from the place, but she filed for maintenance was ordered, and now she is getting maintenance because, and he has come for settlement. You know, that is the way we are trying to kind of strategize to get her relief. But the thing is, at that first stage, they don't even know, dowry act, he has not even gone for the dowry provision, that act has not been used. But the legislations which we kind of use are the 498A, we use maintenance for, and again, maintenance is only to get the way of, it's a strategy, basically to say how we can kind of deal with it, whether they will come. Because in Kerala what happens is, and I'm speaking from a Kerala perspective, because usually when the woman comes for maintenance, we say, I want to go back to my husband's place, and because I don't want to stay with my family, because they are burdened by me. So, okay, let me say, okay, let's find a way. So that is the least harmful, legislation, that is, okay, we can try to save the family as they say. Now, immediately what happened, 125 when we used, the husbands come and they say, we are willing to take her back. Now, willing to take her back on what grounds? That is what we said there. Okay, you go back. But sometimes they will not take her back. Now, okay, they are not willing to take her back. She says, okay, now I want maintenance. Now, whatever. But at the time of marriage, so much of money was given, so much of gold. I need that back. What do? We file a petition under the Family Court Act. That is 7, 7, kind of marriage, so much of money was given, and that was entrusted to the family, and then they have taken to this. Immediately, each girl who comes, they say that the entire gold was taken, and that gold was taken for reconstructing the house or for paying off the husband's loan, or the husband wants to buy a car, to run as a taxi. So immediately, the entire money is gone out. They would use this money to carry out the marriage. The one lakh, and they would take it just before the marriage, engagement time, and that money is used to buy a gift for the customary gift for the bride, even the gold and sari and everything, and even the clothes also bought from the money which is given from the bride's family. The marriage expenses are also through the bride's family, and very happily they do. So this 1 lakh or 2 lakh, 2 lakh or 3 lakh, this is like ordinary family I'm talking about, really ordinary family, and the amount is like 1 lakh, 2 lakh. And we say, this is the name. And immediately an attachment. I mean, these are the strategies which we use so that you get it. And attachment is ordered. When attachment is ordered, okay, the property is there, case is going on. Then they say, no, we did not pay, but there is no proof. Because only family members, and usually it is the father or the mother, father, brothers, these are the people who go to give the money. So it's like an evidence. We have to create an evidence to actually ensure that she gets back that 1 lakh rupees or the gold sovereign. But because there is a general acceptance of the fact that in a marriage that money is given and gold ornaments are given, that is accepted. All the video is shown and all that kind of, she provides those kind of evidences of her testimony and her her family's testimonies are taken. Generally, in Kerala, family court generally give that amount. Then you don't really have to go to the high court. But the thing is, now when we are talking about, if suppose they don't get it, then going to the high court and then to the Supreme Court, very few women actually do that, because the financial background of going up to the high court or the Supreme Court is huge. So because they don't have the financial capacity, sometimes they are not able to reach up to the high court or reach up to the Supreme Court. So even if they don't get it, then their release gets lost. When we talk about 498A, when we were just looking at cases which went up to the High Court or which went up to the Supreme Court, these are all cases where the husband has the, they are the appellants, they are the accused, so they, even if they have been convicted at the lower court, they